It's time now for Writers of the Light. Writers of the Light is a production of the United States Association of Gospel Entertainers and Musicians. We're known as USAGEM, USAGEM. Writers of the Light features our members who are songwriters. They'll be singing their own songs, gospel, Christian, and uplifting songs. So get ready for the light, Writers of the Light. Here's your host, Lynn Fox.
Welcome to USAGEM Writers of the Light. We have a great show here lined up for you today. This is a very special show that we have for USAGEM, and we'd like for you to make welcome now one of the premier songwriters in country and gospel music. This man has written songs for Alabama, for Kenny Rogers, for the Oak Ridge Boys, and the list just goes on and on. And we're so proud to have him here today with us. So this is a special show, and we'd like for you right now to make welcome Mr. Wood Newton.
Hey, so glad to be here tonight with my friend Daniel Johnson here and my new friend Tom Campbell.
Nice to be here.
Daniel and I did some writing, and we were celebrating at Ted's Montana Grill, and they had coasters with some slogans on there, and one of the slogans was from the great Will Rogers, the Cowboy Hall of Fame guy from Oklahoma, and the slogan was, "Don't let your yesterdays use up too much of your today." And the little songwriter light went on over our head. We came up with this song right here.
1, 2, 3, 4.
be here. All right, let me think about what we're going to do next here. You know, I have a song that's one of my most performed songs that I co-wrote with a guy named Michael Noble, who is now a member of the Grand Ole Opry band, staff band. Mm-hmm. And we wrote about 100 songs probably over 3 years with House of Gold and Warner Brothers Publishing. And one of them got cut by the great Steve Warner, one of the certified guitar players.
Yeah.
And I tell you, I wish he was here to play guitar for us today, but I'm going to do this one. It's called It's Not What I Did, It's What I Didn't Do. Letters coming in.
The brain's in.
All right. Hey, well, I was born and raised in a little town called Hampton, Arkansas.
Yeah.
It's down almost to Louisiana, and it's in those piney woods like you find on your way to the coast just about anyway. If you're going down to the Gulf Coast or you're going down into Louisiana. And my daddy was a jack of, he used to say he was a jack of all trades and a master of none, but he was a master of a bunch of them. He was he helped build Fort Pope, Louisiana, back when they didn't have power tools like I have now. And he built chimneys. He was a mason, and then he ended up being having a. And then I'm a big fan of Hank Hill. King of the Hill.
Oh, yeah.
That was my lie.
Yeah.
That was my lie. And Hank, King of the Hill, he was a propane dealer. Well, my dad was a partner with his brother in the propane business down there. And they split up, and Uncle Pete took the propane, and Dad took the hardware store. And so, anyway, he people around there really appreciated him because he could fix anything. And you know, you couldn't buy a new vehicle during World War II. So as soon as they started making, quit making Jeeps and tanks, they started making trucks and cars, and he bought a truck sight unseen. And I think he said he paid $2,000 for it. Wow. And it's the only pickup he ever had. So people, he never had to finance a car. Not like me. I had to finance every day on one of them. And he had a, at the end, in their later years, he had a Cadillac for mama and them to go to church in on Sunday. But he preferred the pickup truck. So anyway, here's a song I wrote about him.
Amen.
Oh, you know, in the bell
Belfast.
Belfast Baptist Church now has a new preacher, and he's standing right here beside me. And he's doing his evangelizing because he got me down there on Father's Day to do some songs. And I did that. He went to heaven in a pickup truck.
You and the other heathens. And,
they really liked it. And where did we do that here?
Yep.
Okay. Well, and what I really liked about there was it was so refreshing and so real when someone read a scripture or said something, they let them know they was with you. You know, they'd say amen. And when I left there, I just stuck with me, and I wrote a song around that. Just in the same key as Daddy went to heaven in a pickup truck, I guess. We might put this in a different order or something like this. We're one of the many congregations, part of our Master's great creation. Because of the blood His Son spilled, we're trying our best to do His will. Let me hear you say amen if you agree.
Amen.
Percentages, you know, 10% used to seem high, but nowadays it seems kind of low.
It has, really.
This song I'm gonna do for you. I was producing and writing with David Ball, the great. Yes, I admit I got a thinking problem.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Love
him.
That song makes me cry because I didn't write that one.
Yeah.
But we did a whole album and we were making the deal on it. We were the record label and everything, but we found a really great indie label and they were just starting off, and their label called Dual Tone, who has gone on to do great things. But we found them at the very beginning. And while we were trying to make this deal, Tom Shepherd and I, a young writer, got together and we wrote this song. He was really into classic cars and he had seen a story, read something on the internet about a guy that had a Corvette that he thought it was haunted because it, the radio station always went to the oldie station.
Oh, isn't that something? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
Anyway, and then David Ball, it took us a while to write this song. I even went to the library and got that coffee table book and we found the perfect Corvette. It was a 1966.
Yep.
Good year.
And when we got ready to shoot the video, I called the Corvette Museum and I told them about it, and they turned me on to a guy here in Nashville who had been a Vietnam vet, and he had a red Corvette and he let us borrow it to shoot the video. So I was involved in all that.
That's great.
Anyway, thanks to my buddy David Bone and Tom Shepard and everybody. I was just out of the service, thumbing through the classified, when an ad that said old Chevy somehow caught my eye. The lady didn't know the year or even if it ran, but I had that $1,000 in my hand. Every way back in the corner of this old ramshackle barn, 30 years of dust and dirt on that green army car. When I pulled the cover off, it took away my breath. What she called a Chevy was a 66 Corvette. And I felt a little guilty as I counted out the bill. What a thrill I got when I sat behind the wheel. I opened up the glove box and that's when I found the note. Date was 1966, this is what he wrote. He said, my name is and if you're reading this, then I didn't make it home. But for every dream that shatters, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of mine, now it belongs to you. And though you may take her and make her your own, you'll always be right. Well, it didn't take me long at all, I had her running good. Love to make those horses thunder underneath her hood. Had her shining like a diamond and I'd put the wreck top down. All the pretty girls would stop and stare as I drove her through town. The buttons on the radio didn't seem to work quite right, but it picked up that only show, especially late. Sometimes if I turn real quick I see soldier riding shotgun in the seat right next to me. But one night it was raining hard and I took a curve too fast. I still don't remember much about that fiery crash. Someone said they thought they saw a soldier pull me out. They didn't get his name, but I know that young man named Private Andrew Malone, too far for his country, never made it home. But for every dream that shatters, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of his back when it was new. And I know I wouldn't be here if he hadn't tagged along.
I'd like to thank you, Wood. What a wonderful job you did.
Oh, man, what a pleasure.
Wow, I just love your songs. And I know you've written songs for Kenny Rogers, and I just love all of your songs. Alabama, I think, and the Oak Ridge Boys have recorded your songs. And so we do appreciate you coming, and I'll tell you, we'd sure love to have you back sometime and do some more of that great music.
That would be my pleasure, man.
All right. Well, thank you. Thank you for watching Writers of the Light. We'd also like to thank Tom Campbell for his work on the fiddle. And, of course, Daniel Johnson for playing the mandolin there for us.
Yeah, some good harmonies all around, too.
there you go. So we've had a great time here. A very special edition of Writers of the Light. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Writers of the Light is brought to you by the United States Association of Gospel Entertainers and Musicians. Our show features artists and songwriters who are members and friends of USAGEM. Our singer-songwriters frequently share their experiences of where, when, and how they began their songwriting journeys. Many artists within the ranks of USAGEM have been blessed with success in the music industry, having appeared on countless television programs, winning Grammy Awards, Dove Awards, USAGEM Awards, and numerous industry honors. In spite of this success, most USAGEM members are down-to-earth servants who work together in promoting their brand of gospel and inspirational music to the world. I'm Lynn Fox, your host of Writers of the Light. For more information on USAGEM and our artists, please visit www.usagem.org. One more thing. If you're enjoying our show, we'd love to hear from you. You can email us at usagemwritersofthelight@gmail.com. Stay tuned to Writers of the Light and check your local listings for dates and times for broadcast of our show, Writers of the Light.